Hello, and a very warm welcome to LMT Royal YouTube channel. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry face having to ask President Trump for special help if they want Secret Service protection for their new life in Los Angeles, as Canadians bid the couple and their security costs farewell. Trump will have the final say over whether the couple can have diplomatic protection in the U.S., because Harry will no longer be classed as an international protected person when he completes the final phase of Mexit next week, according to a royal source. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex and 10-month-old baby Archie made a last-minute dash across the border from Canada to the U.S. this week to start their new life in Los Angeles. Questions are now being asked about who will foot the bill for their new Hollywood lifestyles. The couple caused quite a stir earlier this year when they made the shock announcement that they were quitting royal life and leaving the UK. The Mexit process will finally be complete on Tuesday when the couple will stand down as senior royals. A royal source said the pair's stepping down removes any obligation on the US government to pay for their security. The UK and US have a long-standing reciprocal agreement when it comes to bodyguards protecting diplomats and members of the royal family. President Trump's Secret Service agents would have been allowed to carry their weapons on his state visit, and likewise bodyguards for the Queen and Prince Charles when they made official trips to the US. But Harry's exit from the royal family means he is no longer considered an international protected person, and so these rules don't apply. The couple would now need to rely on President Trump to make an exception to cover the costs, the source said. It will be down to Harry or his Met police protection officers to ask for help, they said. There is a reciprocal agreement between the US that allows protection officers to carry their weapons. But Harry is no longer a serving royal, and that is why his protection in Canada from the Mounties was withdrawn. Someone is going to have to ask the State Department, and ultimately the decision rests with Donald Trump, for assistance. Harry cannot live in the US without armed protection, given Meghan's criticism of the US leader and snubbing him at a Buckingham Palace banquet. He might not feel so generous to the pair. Harry has also been disparaging of Trump during a prank telephone call when he was fooled into thinking he was talking to climate activist Greta Thunberg. The couple will now have to plead with Trump to cover the costs. If he refuses, they will have to pay for private security, or the UK will continue to foot the bill. Under US law, only citizens and permanent residents or green card holders are eligible to own a firearm. Private security guards, who are often ex-military or law enforcement officers, are permitted to be armed. However, royal experts do not believe Harry will turn to a private security firm. The LAPD and California Governor Newsom's office did not return a request from LMT Royal Channel about their involvement in the couple's security plans. Canadian officials repeatedly said they would not pay for Meghan and Harry's security when the Sussexes quit the UK and made the move to Canada. Their protection from the Canadian Royal Mounted Police outside their home in Vancouver was due to cease on the same day that their status as working members of the royal family ends on March 31. Another analysis: why Prince Harry and Prince William have anger and resentment against each other. Prince Harry and Prince William are known to have very different personalities. However, the two brothers were quite close to one another growing up, especially after the death of their mother, Princess Diana. Yet these days, it's clear that Prince Harry and Prince William no longer get along like before. In fact, an insider recently shared that there could be a lot of anger and resentment between them. Now let's find out why. How did the feud between Prince Harry and Prince William start? According to many news reports, the feud between the two princes started in 2016 after Prince Harry started dating Meghan, Duchess of Sussex. Prince Harry reportedly was concerned that his brother and Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, were not being supportive of his relationship, and this caused a rift between them. It was all so quick that William and Kate didn't have a moment to get to know Meghan because Harry hardly knew Meghan, royal expert Ingrid Seward said. And of course, quite naturally, William and Kate would have thought, oh, she's been married before, she's older than Harry, I hope she's going to make him happy. Anyone would think that. However, Prince Harry did not appreciate his relationship being questioned, especially since he was supportive of Prince William and Kate being together from the get-go. According to other sources, Prince Harry and Prince William already had tension between them long before Meghan came into the picture. The two princes have different personalities, so they reportedly just grew apart as they got older. Prince Harry and Prince William still have anger and resentment between them. Things are not looking any better for Prince Harry and Prince William, and it seems like a lot of work needs to be done before their relationship can become normal again. An insider recently told Us Weekly, publicly they've stopped short of trash talking each other. But behind closed doors, they're both filled with anger and resentment. This is reportedly due to Prince Harry's abrupt departure from the royal family. In January, Prince Harry and Meghan announced that they were stepping down as senior members of the royal family. The couple would also be spending a lot of time in North America. Sources allege that Prince William was blindsided by the announcement, and Prince Harry is aware that the move did not do much for improve his strained relationship with his brother. Do Meghan Markle and Kate Middleton get along? It's very possible that Prince Harry and Prince William's rift could spill over into the relationship between their wives. There were rumors that Meghan and Kate did not get along very well when they first met. However, they allegedly grew closer after Meghan became a mother for the first time. It's not clear what their relationship is like today. Some people believe that Meghan and Kate were never actually best friends simply because they are quite different from one another. Other people believe that Meghan's distance from the royal family could help them get closer since Meghan would now, in theory, be happier with her life. In other news, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry set up permanent home in California after fleeing coronavirus lockdown in Canada. Prince Harry and Meghan have left Canada amid the coronavirus pandemic and have moved permanently to California. They took a private flight to the Los Angeles area before the borders between Canada and the US were shut. The Sussexes will set up a new home close to Hollywood, where we are told they are currently living in lockdown with their 10-month-old baby Archie. Last night, a royal insider said, Harry and Meghan have left Canada now for good. The borders were closing and flights were stopping. They had to get out. But this move was planned for some time. They realized Canada would not work out for various reasons, and they want to be based in the Los Angeles area. They have a big support network there. It's where their new team of Hollywood agents and PRs and business managers are based. Meghan has lots of friends there, and of course her mom Doria. This new move stunned and horrified members of the royal family. They believed that Harry and Meghan would consider returning to Britain to help their relatives. A growing health crisis has seen Prince Charles test positive for COVID-19, and the Queen and ailing Prince Philip put into self-isolation. Meghan's return to showbiz. News of the shock move came as US entertainment giant Disney pushed ahead with the release of a charity film about elephants, for which Meghan provides the voiceover. The deal is believed to have been done after Harry cornered the company's boss Bob Iger at the premiere of The Lion King in London last year. Disney sources said the release had been long planned to coincide with Earth Month, which begins next Wednesday and was not changed because of the coronavirus pandemic. The film will raise money for the charity Elephants Without Borders. Our sources say the arrangement is another indication of where the couple see their priorities going forward. The royal insider explained, for Meghan, this type of work is going to be coming out of Hollywood going forward. She feels comfortable there around her people and has projects already planned like her children's book. The Sussexes left the $14 million mansion they were borrowing in Vancouver and took a flight out of the city shortly before US President Donald Trump and Canadian PM Justin Trudeau closed the border between their countries. The couple landed in the Los Angeles area, which includes Bel Air, the posh neighborhood of 1990s Will Smith sitcom The Fresh Prince of Bel Air. Prince Charles and Prince Andrew are both out of action too for very different reasons. This was an opportunity for them to put country before their own interests. California isn't going anywhere. Harry and Meghan's plan to quit the UK in a world exclusive left in January. We told of the couple's plans to relinquish their HRH titles and relocate their office to Canada. Within hours, the Sussexes released a statement confirming the story, but making it clear they wanted to continue conducting some royal duties. Their plan was overruled by the Queen at a historic summit, where it was made clear to the Sussexes they could not remain senior royals while making their own money. She instituted a one-year transition period allowing them to change their mind. They have also been banned from using their Sussex royal moniker in the future, but have been able to keep their Frogmore Cottage mansion at Windsor, even though they have offered to pay back the money taxpayers spent on renovations. There is also a row about whether UK taxpayers should continue to foot the bill for the couple's security, expected to cost up to $26 million annually. Despite the couple's friendship with Mr. Trudeau, Canada has refused to contribute to their security costs after they officially leave the royal family on March 31st. Megxit caused a growing rift between Harry and Meghan, and Prince William and Kate. Harry's relationship with Father Charles has also been left incredibly strained. The Queen has been desperate to ensure Harry and Meghan remain on side with the family. Please support growing LMD Royal Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos us. Your support is the motivation for us to produce better videos. If you have any suggestions for us, please leave your comments below. Don't stop.